Good evening, once again. And Dr. Pijarias knows more of India than we do, especially me. He is so thorough about his knowledge about India and the surrounding areas. Great, sir. Thank you. Great. It was great. Today, I'll be delivering a talk on prevalence of respiratory disease in India. Actually, Dr. Behra, who's from Chandigarh, is supposed to deliver the talk, but some unfortunate circumstances, he could not come, and I'm taking over that, and I got only one day's notice, so please cooperate with me. I'll be discussing only a few things today, because couple of days, other speakers or other faculty will be talking on tuberculosis, bronchiectasis, cystic fibrosis, and fungal diseases. And prevalence of respiratory, you know, India is a large country, as Sir said. It's a large country with geographical, each geographical area got different culture, different food, and different way of style, life, different way of, the style of living is also different. So the prevalence may vary from region to region, from south to north and east to west. So that is it. So you may see some discrepancy in the statistics. Now, what is prevalence? What is prevalence? Actually, it's a statistical concept, prevalence. That is a proportion of the population that has a disease at a point of time and indicates how widespread the disease is. And is it important tool? Yes, it's an important tool. Why? Because it indicates the burden of disease and helps in taking preventive action. So that will definitely help us in tackling the situations. I mean, an example like cigarette smoking, BD smoking, or chewing tobacco and all that. So prevalence is always give a positive way of controlling things. Now, why the spurt in respiratory illness now? Why? Because probably population explosion, not was what it was, urbanization, crowded houses, crowded settlements, lifestyle changes, you know, everything, and atmospheric air pollution. Just now, recently, we had smog at Delhi, pretty bad it was. And the adverse outcome. What is the adverse outcome of respiratory illness? The quality of the life of the individual deteriorates, leading to disability, affecting the productivity, and results in loss of man-hours, which is an economic burden for both the individual and the community. Today, I'm just spending 5 or 10 minutes over these chronic respiratory diseases, the prevalence of which will be discussed in, the prevalence in India. Asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, lung carcinoma, interstitial lung disease. Actually, our registries are not complete. So I cannot give a very conclusive idea about the prevalence. But still, I managed to get some data from here and there and compile in one day. So that's what I, in the beginning of the talk, I said that. The bronchial asthma. Worldwide, the prevalence is 1% to over 20% individuals in different populations in the world. In numbers, the global asthma burden is about 320 million patients. 320 million patients, and this is the worldwide prevalence, and this is the number, in number. The overall, in India, the overall prevalence, according to one study, is clinical asthma for South Asia, that is southern part of India, South Asia, that is including India, South Africa, India, sorry, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, etc., was assessed to be 3.5%. But a study done by S.K. Jindal shows the prevalence of asthma in India about 5% in children, children is more, and 3% in adults, 3% in adults. South India contributes to 5% to 16%, 16.6% highest prevalence over there, north 2.3 to 12.5, probably because of geographical differences and way of life. And of course, you know the offending agents like the pollens and atmospheric pollution, etc. And west 2.4 to 7.3, it shows the least. But this is not a very recent study anyway. And the prevalence of asthma is higher among child population compared to general population. That we have to remember, and as you all are practicing physicians, you will be knowing about it. In such a study, phase 2, the Indian multicentric study, conducted at 12 centers in India in a population sample of 1,69,575, has reported a mean prevalence of 2.05. But another study conducted in 2012, that's a multicentric study again, which showed 2.04% is the prevalence. And why all this prevalence and all this is important? Because cost-wise, the estimated annual burden is about 30 billion rupees, Indian rupees, for patients with chronic asthma, with additional cost of about 5 billion rupees for acute asthma. That probably may be the cost of treatment or asthma in your countries also, the countries you belong to also. This is the INSEARCH phase 2 results. Bars on the left show urban area, on the right is the rural area, and hollow bars represent male population and solid bars represent female population. So look at Calcutta. That is in Bengal, West Bengal. Calcutta is in West Bengal, where the prevalence is more in the urban areas, more in the urban areas than the rural. But male to female ratio, the female ratio in rural area is more. Whereas you come down to Kerala, that is down south, that is Trivandrum, in the urban area, the incidence of prevalence of asthma is much less, while in the rural area it's pretty high. And another interesting factor, in the rural area, the female population is more affected, Actually, I was teaching at Trivandrum Medical College some years back, and I found the same, in the rural areas, the female population suffered the most with asthma. Now I come to COPD. High morbidity and mortality due to COPD in China and India. Bold study from different sites of India, showed a prevalence of 5.7% in Pune, that's Maharashtra, and 17.3% in Srinagar. I attribute this high incidence to hookah smoking. You must have heard about hookah. That is, few people smoking the same thing, and that's a jar-like thing, and probably that is why such high incidence in Srinagar. That's very prevalent over there. An extensive review of literature conducted by Mackay et al. In India showed a prevalence of 4.1% with a male to female ratio of 1.6:1. 1.6:1 male female ratio. And these days, my personal experience here now, that these days, the incidence in the female is also going up. And some attribute it to the biomass fuel, close kitchen, etc. And probably your studies also may be showing that this biomass fuel is a big threat in a closed kitchen because of smaller fuming, because of the fumes. The prevalence was higher among bidi smokers. This is another interesting thing. 8.2% while comparing with 5.9% of cigarette smokers. So bidi smokers are more prone for COPD. And that usually in India, the bidi smokers belong to the lower strata, whereas cigarette smokers from the higher strata. So that is the prevalence rate. Now looking at this side, we have bronchial asthma, chronic bronchitis. Same here, bronchial asthma, chronic bronchitis. Trivandrum, that's the end of southern tip of South India. India, the incidence of chronic bronchitis is 10. And in Kolkata, in West Bengal, the asthma prevalence is 4.82, which is the highest. And here also it's the highest. This is chronic bronchitis and this is asthma. Whereas chronic bronchitis is less in Kolkata and asthma is also less in Trivandrum. So this is a pictorial model to understand the prevalence. Bronchial asthma prevalence in percentage, it's given. Now I'll come to lung cancer. Lung cancer constitutes 14.4% of all cancers. Nowadays the trend is changing, but in India, squamous cell carcinoma is the commonest, followed by small cell and adenocarcinoma. But some literature I gone through, in Western countries, adenocarcinoma is getting an upper hand than the squamous cell. Smoker to smoker, non-smoker ratio is alarming. 20:1. That is 6.9 per 1 lakh of Indian population suffer from lung cancer. 6.9 per 1 lakh. The number of new cases increased from around 65,000 in 2009 to 90,000 in 2013, and it has crossed 1,20,000 in 2017, registering a phenomenal growth of 15% to 20% increase annually. So that is something alarming. Currently 1.5 lakhs new cases are diagnosed in India annually. This may be probably because of better investigations. We have better tools to investigate, like bronchoscope. Usually previously patients used to say no CT, no HRCT, no, I don't want any bronchoscopy done or a lung biopsy done, etc. But people are people are accepting it now these days. It's commonest in men, accounted to 11.3% of all new cancers. In contrast to a decline trend in men in developed countries, in developed countries, the CA bronchus is coming down in males, but the plateau is kept in females. In India, the story is different. The incidence continues to rise for both males and females in India. The National Cancer Registry Program identified lung and upper aerodigestive tract malignancies are most common type in men all over the country with geographical differences. As I told you, India, we have a lot of north to east and east to west and west to north, south, etc. In India, squamous cell carcinoma was the commonest histological type overall in ex and current smokers. Even exposed smokers, squamous cell carcinoma was prevalent, is prevalent. Adenocarcinoma is predominant histological type among the never smokers. Interstitial lung disease. The data of prevalence of ILD in India are scarce. The latest prospective multicentric ILD registry from India that is done in 2016 showing a prevalence of hypersensitivity pneumonitis to 47.3%, connective tissue ILD to 13.9% and IPF to 13.7%. No conclusive study and data available for prevalence of IPF. 1,30,000 potential IPF patients exist in India by conservative estimates. This is only conservative estimates. Now I'll come to sarcoidosis in India. The actual burden of sarcoidosis was never realized because many cases remain undiagnosed and unreported and probably misdiagnosed as tuberculosis. Because that time we never thought we have high prevalence of sarcoidosis in India. And probably that's the reason they were treated for pulmonary tuberculosis especially. It has been estimated that sarcoidosis constituted 10 to 12 cases per 1,000 new registrations in Kolkata. 10 to 12 new cases per 1,000. Whereas in Delhi, it is 61.2 per lakh new cases in VP Chest Institute, Delhi. That's a very prestigious institution. Now, why we are not able to diagnose a lot of interstitial lung disease, which most of us miss it? Especially, these patients come from primary health center, then they see doctors in between, they may go for homeopathy, Ayurveda, and finally comes to us, the tertiary care hospital. So, when it comes to you, you diagnose it, then it may be too late for them to get treated. Sorry. Due to lack of HRCT, because it was about 5 years back, it's not available all over the world, all over India. Now it's available, and patient got a grudge against lung biopsy because it's an invasive procedure. So they have a grudge and they don't agree with it, and so the whole picture is hazy. Males 10.7 per cases per 1 lakh, females 7.4 cases per lakh. No prevalence rates are available as the national registry is not updated. And another interesting factor I see is 40 to 70 years male with male predilection. The age group is 40 to 70 years. Mean age of diagnosis is 66 years because they get lost in primary health center or somewhere else. And between 35 to 44 years, the prevalence is 2.7 per lakh, and above 75 years, 175 per lakh. This is a picture of ILD in India. And thank you very much for our patient hearing. Thank you.